At 2:25 p.m. on a Monday afternoon in January 1990, AT&T Network Operations Center started to get notifications that their network was showing an alarming number of warning signals. This outage had severe repercussions on airlines, businesses, and individuals, resulting in financial losses of over $60 million. AT&T's long-distance network was responsible for handling over 70% of Americans' traffic, routing over 115 million telephone calls. To support this extensive network, AT&T deployed over 114 computer-operated electronic switches across the United States. Each switch can handle up to 700,000 calls per hour. They were interconnected using a cascading network known as CCSS7, which coordinated communications between the switches. When a call was initiated, the local switch would analyze possible routes to complete the call. Eventually, the call would reach the destination switch, where it would be redirected to the recipient's phone line. If the destination switch was unavailable, the original switch would send a message notifying the caller that the recipient was not reachable. A switch located in New York had to undergo a routine maintenance because it was nearing its load limit and was experiencing overloading issues. The switch would temporarily alert other switches that it would stop accepting requests for around 4 seconds. After the reset completed, the New York switch retrieved data from the queue and forwarded the request to the destination switch. The destination switch received the request from the New York switch and updated its record to indicate that the New York switch was back online. In less than 10 milliseconds of the first message, a second message arrived while the first message was still being processed. However, a critical software defect caused the second message to overwrite the communication information. The software in the destination switch detected this overwrite and immediately activated it backed up while attempting to reset itself. Unfortunately, another series of closely timed messages triggered the same issues for the backup. Upon recovery, the destination switch would read from its backlog and propagate the messages back to other switches. This led to a cascading effect across the network. Once the issue has been identified, AT&T rolled back their software to the previous working version. After many hours of debugging, they were able to pinpoint the issue to this block of code provided in the pseudocode. When the first message is received, the program checks if the ring write buffer is empty. If it's empty, it sends a message to the status map indicating that the setting switch is active. This is likely part of a monitoring system to let other switches know that the New York switch is now operational. When the second message arrives within 10 milliseconds, the ring write buffer is not empty since it's still processing the first message, so it goes to the else statement. The break statement is the root cause of the issue because it would exit out of the switch statement without running code on line 11 where the processing of the incoming message happens. This single line right here caused AT&T to lose over $60 million. There are definitely a few takeaways from this error. 1. Just because your software was released and operational, it doesn't mean that it's bug-free. The software update was released months before the incident and underwent extensive testing. This highlights the importance of testing. You should really try to capture all edge cases so that you can sleep better at night. 2. Understanding and mitigating systematic risks. The cascading impact of the single software defect across the entire network illustrates the interconnectedness and vulnerability of complex systems. It's important to design systems with built-in fault tolerance, redundancy, and resilience to minimize the potential for widespread failures. Additionally, you should have an effective recovery plan in place to mitigate the impact of unexpected incidents and be able to restore your system back swiftly. This scenario gave me the chills because it reminded me of a time when I completely wiped out the SIN numbers from our production database. Software is such a complex and ever-evolving beast that it's so difficult to catch everything. Have you ever brought down a production before? I would love to hear about it in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, I would appreciate it if you would consider subscribing to my channel for future videos. And as always, thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.